Hi, my name is Tai-Danae Bradley. I'm a mathematician here at SandboxAQ. I've been here for about 2.5 years, and I'm very excited to have our founder and CEO, Jack Hidary, with us today. Jack, thank you so much for joining. Let's just jump right into it. What is AQ?
AQ encompasses many, many different disciplines. So let's break that down. AQ, AI and quantum. Let's talk about the AI part first. I think most people know that AI is now impacting many parts of our lives, from very, very serious areas such as medical imaging and looking at patient records to glean insights so we have better treatments, to the energy grid, to financial services, but also in very day-to-day aspects of our lives as well. For example, every time you see a Netflix recommendation of a new movie or a new show, that is machine learning behind that. Every time you're on YouTube and see a recommendation of new videos there or on TikTok, these are all machine learning algorithms that are driving these particular services. So machine learning and AI is all around us and will have even a bigger impact, particularly now, and we'll probably get into it in a few minutes, some of the more sophisticated machine learning algos are now just coming out, these LLMs and VLMs. So we'll get into that in a little later, probably in this video. But now let's turn to the Q part. What is quantum? People may have heard of quantum computing, and that is part of what quantum is. But quantum is much more than just quantum computing. There's really three big pillars to quantum technology: quantum computing, quantum sensing, and also quantum safe cybersecurity and quantum communication. So that's a lot. Let's break that down a little bit in terms of what all this quantum stuff is around. And again, people may be surprised to know that quantum is actually already part of our daily lives. How so? Well, if you ever use a laser pointer, a laser is a quantum device developed by a quantum physicist many years ago, and now it's all over the place. We use lasers to do LASIK for our eyes. We use lasers in many other kinds of surgeries and procedures. We use lasers in many parts of our lives. And of course, back in the days of DVDs, which we don't use anymore, they were read by lasers as well. And so another example of quantum in our daily lives is an MRI machine. If people have been inside of an MRI machine to take a scan for medical purposes, that was created by physicists as well for the revolution in medical imaging that MRI has brought us. And that is also a quantum device. And of course, every transistor that forms part of a phone, a laptop, these are quantum devices created by three physicists back at Bell Labs in 1947. And it's very exciting to see quantum already permeated throughout society. But that's really just the beginning, Tai-Danae, because we're about to see in the next 5, 10, 15 years a much bigger impact of quantum technology in all of our lives and in business as well.